Hi everyone, it's Simon Keeling here, weatherweb.net. It is Good Friday, the 29th of March. Thanks again for watching. Remember, we're kept free of charge by the adverts you see around the screen here. It's by you coming back and using the site. That's what keeps us free of charge, so thank you for doing that. Okay, very little change over the coming days. We've got high pressure centred up towards the north, low pressure down towards the southwest. This is the chart for midday today, and you'll notice there that we've got this flow coming in from the east and northeast. We'll just skip forward a couple of days. This is the chart for Easter Sunday. Little change here. High pressure off towards the east with low pressure off towards the west. Flow coming in more from an east to south easterly direction, but keeping most places dry with some good spells of sunshine, but still cold. Pretty breezy to the south too, something just to be aware of if taking part in any activities, particularly sailing. Looks like it will be quite a brisk east to southeast wind. A little bit of cloud and rain affecting southeast Ireland and also the far southwest of England, but generally it's dry. Forward a couple of days again, this is Tuesday, and again high pressure to the north, we've got low pressure to the south, a stronger easterly flow by then, making it feel bitterly cold again in the south, but still sunny spells around, the best of them out towards the west. One or two showers perhaps just affecting eastern Scotland and northeastern England, those coming in as being quite wintry, but really the emphasis is on the cold weather. And we could be finding winds perhaps up to as much as 30 miles an hour affecting eastern and southern areas, so for those of you who are sailing, that's around about a 4.6, but touching 4.7 at times offshore. So the easterly wind sticks with us, but what actually happens as we go a little bit further ahead? Well, this is the chart for the 5th, so this is next Friday, and you notice here from the ECMWF, just look at the comparison here between the models. This is the ECMWF, brings in a cold northeasterly. We've got a cold pool here down towards the south as well, indicative that we could see some showers across central and southern parts of the country, probably turning quite wintry. High pressure though out towards the west, look, huge ridge out here which is basically blocking the westerly progression across the Atlantic, forces the air to the north and forces in this north to northeasterly wind, basically keeping us cold. Forward to Saturday, still got this northerly flow down through the country, still got the ridge out towards the west. Sunday though, look, something changes. We've still got the ridge out towards the west here, but we're starting to see the flow perhaps turning more into the southwest, out towards the west of the country. Cold though, across much of the country with that north and northwesterly wind. Now by the 8th, which is next Monday, what we're seeing here is the ridge building its way eastwards, look through the country, and hints of a mild southwesterly flow. However, don't get too excited, because this low out towards the west is being blocked off by high pressure to the north. And so the position of this low, if it does develop, is likely to pass through the country, bringing more unsettled conditions. But it would break down this cold block that we've seen. So the ECMWF wants to break it down. What about the Canadian? Well, this is the Canadian model for the 5th. Look, there's our ridge out towards the west. Into the 6th, the ridge has built across the country into the west of us. again, this flow being forced around the north and down southward. But you see, the GEM making less of that northerly through the UK. Now by the 7th, so this is Sunday the 7th of April, still got the ridge through the country, look, got that northerly flow towards the east, but we are starting to pick up a little bit of a mild southwesterly flow coming over the top, although it will still be pretty cold and generally dry. Then for the Monday, well, the ridge is there, look. So similar kind of overall pattern with the idea of this ridge being in. The Canadian making less of the low out towards the west, still got a low up towards the north though. And what would happen with this pattern is that the low here would probably track to the north of the country, maintaining high pressure across the southern parts of the UK. So we've got one model going for the potential for milder but potentially wetter conditions middle of the month, another one going dry. And this is just the GFS ensemble. I wanted to show you this because this one goes further ahead. It's very similar in its early stage evolution, but this goes forward to Friday the 12th now. And what I wanted to show you here is just, it's interesting that this ridge is still in here, look. We've got high pressure centred out here and low pressure out towards the west. So I think this overall pattern that we're going to pick up on is one of staying generally dry across the southern parts of the UK and Ireland, some rain affecting the north and the west of Scotland, but possibly becoming milder. It's this period between the 8th and the 10th, I think, when we could see temperatures start to pick up, probably to nearer the seasonal normal. But there are these hints that milder weather will try to get in. Now, the Japanese longer-range model has just been released as well. So how does that see things? Well, this is the first week. So this is running through from the data time of yesterday. And this will take us up to Friday the 5th. So this is next Friday. So this is week one. And what this is showing us here is rainfall totals, look here, probably below normal, but it's also showing us these below normal heights down to the south, above normal up to the north, so it kind of fits in with the other things that we've seen. Then looking at week two, which takes us forward from Saturday the 6th through to Saturday the 13th of April, so this is into the middle of the month, and what I want you to notice here, look, is it is starting to try and change things a bit. Heights a little bit below normal compared to the average. Rainfall showing up as more luck across southern parts of the UK and Ireland. So this hint of potentially more unsettled conditions. This is backing up this idea of the ECMWF of becoming more unsettled briefly for that middle part of the month. And then the final 2 weeks of the month. So this taking us forward from Saturday the 20th through to the early part of May. And this then picks up on pressure building generally. It shows us above normal heights across the country, but it shows, look, the blue colours affecting Ireland and western parts of Scotland. It hints at those western areas being wetter, with the east and south being drier, which would be indicative of a ridge of high pressure building across the south. So it's backing up the ideas there of the GFS ensemble. So where do we go? Well, I think what we can say is that we are going to be dry probably up to around about the 10th of April, something like that. Then I think we're probably going to go into a more unsettled period. It's somewhere from about the 10th through to around about the 16th that we see this risk of more unsettled conditions. Then towards the end of the month, so we're picking up from about the 17th onwards, then we probably get into a pattern of the west being wetter, so Western Ireland, northern and western parts of Scotland seeing most of the rain, but for more southern and eastern areas probably staying dry and probably becoming milder too. But I think during this early period we are staying cold, then we become cool, and then probably go milder in that middle part of the month. Sorry, I should say towards the end of the month. So hopefully that's given you some idea as to where we are as of this morning. So once again, thanks for watching weatherweb.net. Remember, we're kept free of charge by the adverts you're seeing around the screen here. It's by you coming back and using the site that keeps us free of charge. So thank you for doing that. And for now, have a great day and keep the sun shining. Bye for now.